In the previous class, we started with the short run cost curves, and we have already seen total fixed cost, total variable cost, and total cost. Let us see the average fixed cost, the average variable cost, and average cost. So, what do you mean by fixed cost? Fixed cost does not change with a change in the quantity of output. Fixed cost does not change. It remains the same. Even if the output increases or decreases, or even if the output is zero, the total cost remains the same, or the total cost is a constant. The expenses on fixed factors remain unchanged irrespective of the level of output. For example, rent of the factory, watchman's wages, permanent workers' salaries, all comes under the total fixed cost. So let us study about the average fixed cost. How do you calculate average fixed cost? Average fixed cost is obtained by dividing the total fixed cost by the quantity of output. Mathematically, AFC is equal to TFC divided by Q. So what is average fixed cost? It refers to the fixed cost per unit of output. So average fixed cost means it is the cost per unit of output, or it is the cost incurred for the production of one unit of a commodity. An example is given here. If the total fixed cost is 1000 and the quantity of output is 10, how will you calculate AFC? For that, you make use of the formula AFC is equal to TFC divided by Q. TFC is 1000 and the quantity of output is 10. So 1000 divided by 10 will give you 100. So the cost of producing one unit is rupees 100. Now coming to this table, the quantity is given here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and the total fixed cost for producing 0 items, the cost is 1000. For producing 1, it is 1000. For producing 2, it is 1000. For producing 3, it is 1000. So what do you observe here? Even if the output is 0, you have the total fixed cost. As the output increases, there is no change in the total fixed cost. It remains a constant. So how do you calculate AFC? The formula for calculating AFC is TFC divided by Q. So 1000 divided by 0, infinitive. 1000 divided by 1, 1000. 1000 divided by 2, 500. 1000 divided by 3, 333. 1000 divided by 4, 250, and 1000 divided by 5, 200. Now let us plot the points given in the table and draw the graph. On the x-axis, we have taken the quantity produced. The quantity produced is given as 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the quantity of, and the average fixed cost. What is the average fixed cost? 1000, 500, 333, 250, and 200. So for convenience sake, we have just marked whatever is given in the table. But usually in the maths graph, you would have learnt in your lower classes, you would have written something called as the scale. On the x-axis is equal to 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit, y-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. It must be a standard. Each unit must have the same quantity, but here it is not like that. Actually, they should have taken it as 200, 400, 600, 800, and 1000, but they have just marked it as 200, 250, 333, 500, and 1000. So you can also learn it in this way itself. So the first one, when the output is 1, I am taking from 1, when the output is 1, the average fixed cost is 1000. So this is the point. When the output is 1, the cost is 1000. When the output is 2, the cost is 500, this point. When the output is 3, it is 333. Output 4, it is 250. When the output is 5, it is 200. Okay. Now join all these points. If you join all these points, you get a curve. This curve is called as the average fixed cost curve, AFC. AFC means average fixed cost curve. Did you understand this? Now what it has to be noted that AFC curve declines as output increases. As output increases, AFC declines. So can you see this curve? AFC curve is a downward sloping curve. AFC declines from 1000, it has come to 500, 333. So AFC declines as output increases from 0, 1, 2, 3. As output increases, AFC declines. The second one, AFC curve is downward sloping curve throughout its length. So throughout its length, it is a downward sloping curve. And it does not touch the x-axis and the y-axis. It does not touch the x-axis. AFC does not touch the x-axis. AFC does not touch the y-axis also. So it is asymptotic. It is asymptotic to both the axes. It means it does not touch both the x-axis and the y-axis. The shape of AFC curve is a rectangular hyperbola. This is only called as rectangular hyperbola. So this is all about AFC. Now let us go on to AVC. What do you mean by V? It is variable cost. Variable cost means the cost changes. As the level of output increases, the average variable cost increases. So it refers to the total variable cost per unit of output. So it is the cost incurred to produce one unit of a commodity. It is obtained by dividing total variable cost by the quantity of output. AVC is equal to TVC by Q. An example is given here. When AVC is 300 and the quantity produced is 2, calculate AVC. How do you calculate AVC? You just substitute 300 and 2 here. AVC is equal to 300 divided by 2. 300 divided by 2 will give you 150. Here, if TVC is equal to Q power 3 minus 18Q square plus 91Q, how do you calculate AVC? It is just you have to divide TVC by Q, quantity. Here, the variable is Q, so divide by Q. Q cube divided by Q will give you Q square. 18Q square divided by Q will give you 18Q. 91Q divided by Q will give you 91. So this is AVC. Now come to the tabular column. Quantity in unit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Look at TVC. It increases. As output increases, the variable cost. Variable means it keeps changing. Fixed means it does not change. Here the variable cost increases as the output increases. For one unit, the variable cost is 200. For two, it is 300. For three units, it is 400. For four, it is 600. And for five, it is 900. So how do you calculate TVC, AVC? AVC is equal to TVC divided by Q. 0 by 0, 0. 200 by 1, 200. 300 by 2, 150. 400 by 3, 133. 600 by 4, 150. 900 divided by 5 is equal to 180. Now, by using this table, we can plot the graph. On the x-axis, quantity is marked. On the y-axis, average variable cost. So, start from 1. When the output is 1, the total variable cost is 200. When the output is 1, the total variable cost is 200. So this is the point. Output is 1 and total variable cost is 200. when the output is 2, the total variable cost is 150. When it is 3, it is 133. When it is 4, it is 150. When it is 5, it is 180. So by joining all these points, you get a curve, U-shaped curve, which is called as the average variable cost curve. Average variable cost curve. Okay, so this is average variable cost curve. So what are the characteristics of average variable cost? ABC declines initially. Let me take the laser. Okay, ABC declines initially and then increases with the increase in the output. As the output increases, the ABC also increases. So initially the ABC curve declines, reaches a minimum point, and then it increases. Second point, ABC declines up to a point and moves upward steeply due to the law of returns. So ABC curve declines up to a point and moves upwards. Why does it move upwards? Because of the law of returns. So I want to repeat it again. ABC declines. Initially it declines and then increases with the increase in the output. Then next point, ABC declines up to a point and moves upwards steeply due to the law of returns. Last one, ABC curve is a U-shaped curve. ABC curve is a U-shaped curve. The last one, average total cost or average cost. You can either say average total cost or average cost. Average total cost means it is ATC, average cost is AC. So average total cost or AC can be obtained by two ways. It can be obtained in two ways. First one, ATC is equal to TC by Q. You can just divide total cost by the quantity by dividing the firm's total cost TC by the quantity of output. ABC is equal to TC divided by Q. So an example is given here. I think if you look at this example, you can understand it better. If total cost is 1600 and the quantity of output is 4, what is ATC? ATC is 1600 divided by 4, which will give you 400. Similarly, it is given like in an equation form, TC is equal to Q power 3 minus 18 Q square plus 91 Q plus 12. How do you calculate AC? Just divide TC by Q. Since the variable here is Q, we divide by Q. If the variable is P, we divide by P. So here Q cube minus Q will give you Q square. 18 Q square divided by Q will give you 18 Q. 91 Q divided by Q will give you 91. Plus 12. 12 divided by Q is 12 divided by Q. So look at this table. Output is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Total fixed cost is 1000. Total variable cost is 0. So what is total cost? TFC plus TBC, 1000. 1000 plus 200, 1200. Now how do you calculate ATC? ATC divided by Q. 1000 divided by 0, infinitive. 1200 divided by 1, 1200. 1300 divided by 2, 650. 1400 divided by 3, 466. 1600 divided by 4, 400. 1900 divided by 5 will give you 380. The second way of calculating average cost is ATC is divided by adding together AFC and ABC. You just add AFC and ABC. Example, if AFC is 500 and ABC is 150, how do you calculate ATC? It is just adding AFC plus ABC, that is summation of AFC plus ABC. 500 plus 150 will give you 650. Look at the table now. Q is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. AFC is given 0, 1500, 333, 250, 200. ABC 0, 200, 150, 133, 150, 180. How do you calculate ATC? Just add AFC and ABC. 0 plus 0, 0. 1000 plus 200, 1200. 500 plus 150, 650. 333 plus 133, 466. 250 plus 150, 400. 200 plus 180, 380. This is the second way of calculating AC. Now, with the help of the table, we can plot the graph. X-axis, we have taken the output. On the y-axis, average cost is marked. So, for 1 unit, I am starting with 1. For one unit, the average cost is 1200. So, this is the point. For 1 unit, the cost is 1200. For 2 units, the cost is 650. For three units, the cost is 466. This is 466. For 5, it is 400. 400 is here. For 4, it is 400. And for 5, it is 380. Now join all these points, okay? And even if you have 6 or 7, you can mark it. And this is the ATC curve. This is called as the ATC curve. So, ATC curve is also a U-shaped curve. ATC curve is a U-shaped curve. Let me erase all these points. ATC curve is also a U-shaped curve. Why do you say also a U-shaped curve? Because ABC was also a U-shaped curve. ABC is also a U-shaped curve. So, ABC and AC are U-shaped curves. Initially, the ATC declines, reaches a minimum point, okay? And when the plant is operated optimally and rises beyond the optimum output. So, what happens? ATC curve declines, reaches a minimum, and when the plant is operated to the fullest, again, ATC curve increases. So, it takes a U-shape. The U-shape of the AC reflects the law of variable proportions. So, we have studied about the average fixed cost curve. Then the average variable cost curve. Lastly, we saw the average cost or average total cost.